बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम। अस्सलाम वालेकुम स्टूडेंट्स, आई होप यू ऑल आर डूइंग वेल। आई एम योर इंग्लिश टीचर। स्टूडेंट्स, एज यू नो दैट आर रिवीजन हैड स्टार्टेड एंड वी हैव डन रिवीजन ऑफ डिफरेंट चैप्टर्स। टुडे वी विल डू अ वर्कशीट दैट कंसिस्ट ऑफ डिफरेंट topics which you can see on your screen. Students, first we will revise these topics, then I'll explain worksheet. Students, we have read about the different types of adjectives in the previous classes, and we also read about interrogative and emphasizing adjectives in chapter number 1 of your grammar tree book 5. So first we will discuss chapter number 1, that is interrogative and emphasizing adjective. Interrogative adjectives. Students, an interrogative adjective is used with a noun that it qualifies to ask a question. Students, interrogative adjectives are those adjectives that are used with those nouns that used to ask a questions, that are basically WH words. Students, interrogative adjectives noun ke saath use hote hain aur question poochne ke liye use kiye jaate hain. For example, which part of the world do you come from? Students, in this example, which is an interrogative adjective and it qualifies the noun part and it also asks a question. Second example is, what gift did you get on your birthday? Students, here what is an interrogative adjective and it qualifies the noun gifts and it also asks a question. Now move towards emphasizing adjectives. Emphasizing adjectives. An emphasizing adjective is used to emphasize or heighten the effect of what we say. Students, emphasizing adjectives are used to highlight the speaker's words. Emphasizing adjectives speaker के अल्फाज को highlight करने के लिए या उनको emphasize करने के लिए use किए जाते हैं. For example, what the man said was absolute rubbish. Students, in this example, the word absolute qualifies the noun rubbish. It is an emphasizing adjective. It has been used to emphasize the worthlessness of what the man said. It was not only rubbish but absolute rubbish. Students, यहाँ पर absolute emphasizing adjective है और ये rubbish noun को highlight करने के लिए use किया गया है. Second example is, Jack built this house with his own hands. Students, in this example, the word own is an emphasizing adjective. Here, the speaker wants to make it clear how hard Jack had worked to build the house. So, the word own has been used for the sake of highlight and qualifies the noun hands. Students, now we will revise the adverbs and its types. You all know that adverbs are those words that are used to qualify the verb, adjective, and another adverb. We have read different types of adverbs in chapter number 2 of your grammar tree book 5. Let's take a look. Adverb of degree or extent. Degree means the amount or level of something. Students, degree means amount ya kisi cheez ka level. Students, we use adverb of degree to highlight the amount and level of something. For example, these shoes are too big for you. Here, too is an adverb. and it tells us how big the shoes are. In this example, adverb to qualifies the adjective big. Second example is, this is a very difficult question. Students, in this example, very is an adverb and it tells us how difficult the question is. That is the extent of its difficulty. So it qualifies the adjective difficult. Students, an adverb can also qualify another adverb to indicate to what extent. Students, adverb किसी दूसरे adverb की limits को या उसकी वसत को describe करने के लिए भी use किया जाता है. For example, Kiran did very well in the examination. Here, very is an adverb and it tells us how well Kiran did in the examination. Here, the adverb very qualifies the adverb well. Second example is, Ayan won his match pretty easily. Here, adverb pretty tells us how easily Ayan won his match. The adverb pretty qualifies the adverb easily. Adverb of degree can also be used to qualify verbs. Students, as I told you, ke ek adverb kisi verb ki quality ko bhi describe karne ke liye use kiya jata hai. For example, he really liked the song. Second example is, Sidra almost fainted at the news. Students, here really is an adverb and it is used to qualify the verb liked. Similarly, in second example, fainted is a verb and adverb almost is used to qualify it. Let's move on. Adverb of frequency and time. Adverbs which tells us how often or frequently something happens or is done are known as adverb of frequency. Students, ऐसा adverb जो हमें ये बताता है कि कोई काम कितना जल्दी होता है, वो adverb of frequency कहलाता है. An adverb of time tells us when something happens. और adverb of time हमें ये बताता है कि कोई काम कब हुआ, यानी कि किसी भी एक्शन के परफॉर्म होने का वक्त बताता है. An adverb of time answers the question when. An adverb of frequency answers the question how often. Students, adverb of time हमें एक्शन का वक्त बताता है कि कोई एक्शन कब किस वक्त पर हुआ, जबकि adverb of frequency हमें ये बताता है कि कोई काम कितनी जल्दी हुआ या होता है. Let's move on. Interrogative adverb. Adverbs which are used to ask questions are called interrogative adverbs. Students, ऐसे adverb जो के कोई question पूछने के लिए use किए जाते हैं, वो interrogative adverbs कहलाते हैं. For example, why have you not done your work? Students, here why is an interrogative adverb. In this example, why means for what reason work was not done. So it is considered to be an adverb of reason. Second example is, when did Jane come home last night? Students, here when is an interrogative adjective and it means, sorry, in this question, when means at what time. It is acting like an adverb of time. Students, now we will revise transitive verb and intransitive verb. Transitive verb. A verb which has an object is known as a transitive verb. Students, when the subject of a verb acts and the action affects another person or thing, that person or thing is called the object of the verb. In other words, if the action starts from the subject and ends with the object, दैट वर्ब इज कॉल्ड ट्रांजिटिव वर्ब. यानी जब सब्जेक्ट किसी दूसरी चीज़ या शख्स पर अफेक्ट करता है तो वो चीज़ या शख्स ऑब्जेक्ट कहलाती है. यानी अगर एक्शन सब्जेक्ट से शुरू होकर ऑब्जेक्ट पर ख़त्म हो तो वो वर्ब ट्रांजिटिव वर्ब होगा. या हम यूँ भी कह सकते हैं कि एक ऐसा वर्ब जो जिसमें ऑब्जेक्ट हो वो ट्रांजिटिव वर्ब कहलाता है. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, शाजिया एट एन एप्पल. एट इज़ अ ट्रांजिटिव वर्ब बिकॉज इट हैज़ एन ऑब्जेक्ट एप्पल. ही ड्राइव्स अ कार. ड्राइव्स इज ऑल्सो अ ट्रांजिटिव वर्ब बिकॉज इट हैज़ एन ऑब्जेक्ट कार. ओके, नाउ कम टू द इंट्रांजिटिव वर्ब. स्टूडेंट्स, अ वर्ब विच डज नॉट हैव एन ऑब्जेक्ट इज नोन एज इंट्रांजिटिव वर्ब. Students, when the action described by the verb does not affect some other person or thing, or it stops with the subject, it is called intransitive verb. Students, जब verb किसी दूसरी चीज या शख्स पर असरअंदाज नहीं होता और subject पर ही stop हो जाता है तो वो इंट्रांजिटिव वर्ब कहलाता है. या हम यूँ भी कह सकते हैं कि एक ऐसा वर्ब जिसमें ऑब्जेक्ट ना हो वो इंट्रांजिटिव वर्ब कहलाता है. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, द डॉग बार्क्ड. स्टूडेंट्स, हियर बार्क इज एन इंट्रांजिटिव वर्ब बिकॉज इट सिंपली टेल्स अस समथिंग अबाउट द डॉग, दैट इज द सब्जेक्ट. इट डज नॉट टेल्स अस हाउ द सब्जेक्ट्स एक्शन अफेक्टेड सम अदर पर्सन और थिंग. Second example is birds fly. Students, fly is also an intransitive verb because the action of flying does not pass from birds to some other thing or person. Okay, let's move on. Students, now we will revise prefixes and suffixes. Students, a prefix is a letter or group of letters added to the beginning of a word to form a new word, the meaning of which is usually different in some way from that of the original word. Students, prefix वो letters या group of letters होते हैं जो किसी भी word के शुरू में add किए जाते हैं to form a new word, और इसके meaning original word से different होते हैं. For example, dis plus like is equal to dislike, in plus sane is equal to insane. Students, like and sane are original words and we added few letters to the beginning of these words to form a new word, that are dislike and insane. Okay, now come to the suffixes. A suffix is a letter or group of letters added to the end of a word to form a new word. The meaning of the new word is usually different from that of the original word. Students, suffixes wo letter ya letters ka group hota hai jo kisi word ke aakhir mein naya word banane ke liye add kiye jate hain. Us naye word ke meaning original word se mukhtalif hote hain. For example, help plus full is equal to helpful. Kind plus ness is equal to kindness. Students, here help and kind are original words and we added few letters to the end of these words to form a new words, that are helpful and kindness. Okay students, now move towards worksheet. Students, now you can see a worksheet on your screen. The picture of this worksheet is not clear here, but don't worry, I'll explain each question separately. Students, I hope you all have received this worksheet from school. If you have not received yet, kindly come to school and get it from me. This worksheet has 4 questions. Now move towards question number 1. Students, first write your name and today's date on the worksheet, then paste it in your English language copy. Question number 1 is, underline the adjectives in the following sentences and say of what kind each is. Students, this question is related to chapter number 1, that is interrogative and emphasizing adjective. First, you have to underline the adjective, then write its type in the given space. Sentence number 1 is, which animal is known as the ship of the desert? Students, here which is an interrogative adjective. So, first underline it, then write its type in the given space. Students, it qualifies the noun animal and also asks a question. Students, do rest of the sentences of question number 1 by your own self. Question number 2 is, state what kind each of the underlined adverbs is. Students, this question is related to chapter number 2, adverbs. Students, here adverbs are already underlined. You have to write the types of underlined adverbs. Sentence number 1 is, I have often told you not to speak so loudly. Students, here two adverbs, often and so, are underlined. Yes, tell me the types of these underlined adverbs. Yes, often is an adverb of frequency and it qualifies the verb told. So is an adverb of degree and it qualifies the adverb loudly. Students, write the kind of adverbs often and so in the given space and do all the sentences of this part. Question number 3 is, in the following sentences, state whether the underlined verbs are transitive or intransitive in the blanks given. Also, circle the objects of the transitive verbs. Students, here verbs are underlined. You have to write the kind of verb in the given space. In case of transitive verb, you have to circle the object. Sentence number 1 is, we usually walk back home from school. Students, here walk is an underlined verb and it is intransitive verb, because here subject does not affect any other thing or person. Intransitive verb does not have object, so you just have to write the intransitive verb in the given space. Okay, students, it's very easy exercise. Do all sentences of this exercise by your own self. Question number 4 is, fill in the blanks with words formed by adding prefixes or suffixes to the words given in brackets. Students, this exercise is related to chapter number 4, prefixes and suffixes of your grammar tree book. Students, here you have to form prefixes or suffixes to the words given in the brackets. Students, do all sentences of this exercise by your own self. Students, first update the index, then solve this worksheet. Students, I am telling you again, if you have not received this worksheet yet, kindly come to school and collect it from me. Inshallah, we will revise new chapter in the next session. Thank you. Till then, take care of yourself and your family. Allah Hafiz.